I'm Vicky Bly for Absolute 80s Backstage at Let's Rock the Moor in Cookham. It is the first of the Let's Rock concerts, and I'm joined by the one, the only, Hot Chocolate.
Hey.
Look at these smiles.
I know, we're happy.
That's good. Are you well fed? Have we fed and watered you so far?
You have indeed. The curry's absolutely delicious.
I've just had a large curry, beautiful.
Is that something that usually goes on your rider? You know, a good curry and plenty of red wine, I think I saw you drinking.
We don't drink before we go on stage, though.
Yeah.
He does.
Yeah.
He does.
I do. I get my courage from a bottle. And I get my warmth from my curry.
I think that's a winning combination. It surely is. How many years is it now, dare I ask, since the humble beginnings of Hot Chocolate?
Since 1970. So that's nearly 45 years.
What? That long?
Yeah.
Wow. And in terms of longevity, you guys are the masters of it and perform now as
old.
If you perform now as you did throughout the 70s, throughout the 80s. Absolutely 80s, we would like to say we're very sorry to hear about the sad news that you guys received last week. Errol was such an inspiration for so many musicians, and on Absolute 80s as well. He's a hero, so we're very sorry to hear that. Today, moving to today, the sun's out. The crowd are in fancy dress. What can the fans expect?
More music, more singing, more dancing, more hot chocolate, more happiness, more everything.
Hopefully they're going to get all the songs. Well, they are going to get all the songs that they like and they sing along to.
So all the hits set today.
Yes. Everything.
Well, we
60
got,
thing.
We haven't got long enough to do all of them. We're not playing long enough, but we'll do all the best ones.
We'll do all the best ones.
Yeah. So it should be all right.
We'll do all the number ones.
All the number ones. This is going to be a great show.
Yeah.
You've played these songs countless times.
So we're quite good at it now.
Yeah, you're, I've noticed.
Does
your favourite in terms of performance now, not necessarily your favourite from writing or back in the day, but from being on stage and performing to the audience, does that kind of rotate year by year, or is there one song that the band just literally, you look at each other, nod, and it's that special moment for you all?
Well, we like all of them.
I can't quite honestly say that there is one that I like more. There's bits of ones I'm not liking too much, and others, you know, maybe backing vocals I like.
Yeah. the band may not like bits and pieces, but what we do is we perform for the audience. As long as the audience liking it and enjoying it, that's what matters most.
I think it's a performance as well. We try to... It's like an athlete, you know, you've done 100 metres countless times.
Yeah.
Every time you do it, it's like the first time.
Yeah.
And I think that's the best way to describe it. Really.
And we play them slightly different.
Yeah.
Just not totally different, slightly different. And that makes it so that you're not doing exactly the same thing all the time.
And also for the fans as well that come and see you repeatedly, to know that they probably spot those little subtle changes and they love it. What's the biggest gesture that you've ever had from a fan?
Well, biggest gesture?
What's the biggest one? Right.
Dare I ask? Now there's a question.
That's right.
I thought you were going to keep it simple.
Well, what we've seen in the audience in our career with Hot Chocolate is to witness Her Majesty and Prince Philip waltzing around at Buckingham Palace to "You Sexy Thing." And they don't get any better than that.
She actually breakdowns as well, did she?
She did.
Casting our mind back, we're talking July 1981, and you played the pre-wedding reception for Prince Charles and Princess Diana. Did you have to pinch yourselves? I mean, what was the view that you were looking out on, apart from Charles and Diana breakdancing on the floor? But
We were looking at a lot of famous royalties and people enjoying themselves, which is what we were hoping for at the beginning, that we went there to make sure that the people who wanted us there were really enjoying themselves. And by enjoying themselves, we were enjoying ourselves as well.
And reminding ourselves at Absolute 80s that the man that was such a huge influence for getting your music and sort of getting it on a label was Beatle John Lennon. Is that right?
Yeah, go on.
John Lennon was his secretary, actually.
Got us on the Apple label.
Yeah, he got you onto the Apple label. Because you did a version of a Beatles track, and then.
Right. I'm the one to answer that question. Because.
It was a long time ago. It's very fuzzy.
Yeah, no, honestly, Errol, who is no longer with us, and Tony Wilson took the song down to Apple Records, a version of Give Us a Chance, which we had done. And they quite liked it and decided to release it on the Apple label for us. Yeah, so it was, John Lennon had a lot to do with it.
That's incredible. Those are some serious name drops. John Lennon, Prince Charles and Diana. Yeah. It's been lovely chatting to you. Just finally, what does the summer hold for you as a group and the rest of the year as well? What are the plans over the next few months?
Loads of festivals. Festivals galore. And the more the merrier.
Somebody said recently, is there too many festivals out there? I don't think there is. We enjoy it.
There should be more festivals like this one. There should be many, many, many more. Bring it on.
Bring the people together.
Absolutely.
As long as we can rely on some weather, then it's going to be a great day. Hot chocolate here backstage at Let's Rock Them All.
Bye. Bye. Thank you.